Hello there. In today's episode, I'm going to very quickly run you through Docker, how to use it, very quickly what it is. And I'm not going to get too into the terminology and nitty-gritty, but I'm going to give you enough just to kind of get using it and to get a brief understanding of it. So let's jump in. To get started, go to docker.com and somewhere on the homepage, there'll be a link saying get started for free. And to click that, and what you're looking for is you want to download the desktop application. So you can download this for Mac, for Windows, and there is a way to install it on Linux as well. Linux has the best performance, but Mac and Windows have a nice GUI application. Once you kind of go through that, you go through all that installation, you're gonna have Docker Desktop. And this is like the nice little app where you can manage your containers and view what images have been downloaded, which is very cool. And also, when you go to terminal, you'll have the Docker command available, which lets you kind of do all the wonderful stuff. It lets you do like run the images in the containers and download stuff and push stuff up and all that. And we'll cover some of that in today's episode. Let's jump in and do some stuff with Docker. So right now on my machine, I have Ruby version 3, and that's cool. But let's say I want to very quickly run an older version of Ruby. I don't want to have to set it up and install it. Perhaps I'm on someone else's machine. They have Docker installed and they have nothing to get Ruby installed. So I know it's going to be a really hard piece of work just to do one thing. But what I can do is docker run dash dash rm dash it and then type the image name of Ruby 2.7.2 and then Alpine. I'm going to explain all these individual bits in just a moment. Cool. So that's just given me an interactive terminal. So I could do 1, 2, 3, 4 dot join, and there you go. It's just joined 1, 2, 3, and 4. That's cool. And if I type Ruby version, which will give me the Ruby version, we can see we're running 2.7.2, which is pretty cool. So we then have that interactive terminal. So that's very magical. This is quite fun, this command. So what we're telling Docker here is we'd like to run an image. And we're passing in these two flags here. Dash dash rm means remove this when it's completed. So any dangly bits of disk space get removed and tidied up, which is nice. Dash it means interactive TTY. That means we jump straight into the terminal. And then we pass in the image name. So in this case, I'm asking for Ruby version 2.7.2. And the really cool thing here is this dash Alpine. So there's lots of different flavors of these images we could be running. So you could have like Buster, Slim Buster, Stretch, and a few others. However, Alpine is a very, very small distribution of Linux, which is really good for Docker. The really nice thing is this Ruby 2.7.2. It's only about 50 megs. So if I was maybe on a slower internet connection, I just download this tiny copy of this image and it takes up very little space and I can just then run Ruby, which is really nice. I like it. Okay, I'm in VS Code now and I have a little file called app.rb, which just outputs some text. So if I have Ruby installed, I could just run Ruby app.rb and it would run the file. But let's say I want to send this to a friend. They have Docker installed, they don't have Ruby. I don't want to put them through like having to install Ruby just to kind of run my little script. So it'd be really cool if I could just send them like a pre-built image where they could just run it. So we can do that with Docker files, which is really magical. So what I have here is a Docker file where it says, okay, start with the base image of Ruby 3.0 Alpine. So it's going to be like 50 megabytes. And we're going to say, make this directory called user source app. That's a convention of Docker's as to where you should put your apps. We're going to set out the working directory. We're going to copy the files in from here. So this app is going to be pulled into the image and it's going to be available in this directory. And then finally, we're going to set this method called command. And what that's going to do is that's going to define the command which runs when the Docker image is run by someone running it. So that's quite cool. So let me just show you this. So what we're going to do is we're going to do Docker build and we're going to give it a tag and that just gives us a nice way to reference it later. So I'm going to call this local my app, and I'm going to call it latest. And then we're going to put a dot on the end. And the dot says, go build the Docker file you find in this directory. In this case, it's this Docker file here. So it's going to pull this way up. And there you go. So that's built really quickly. So that's that done there. So we now have an image on our local machine called local my app latest. Okay, so let's run it. So let's do Docker run dash dash rm dash it, and let's see what this does. Cool, it's just outputted, hello, I'm in Docker. So that's really cool. So what I could potentially do here is I could push this image up to Docker Hub and share it with my friends, kind of like how the Ruby images are shared between people, and they could just run them locally. So I think that's really powerful, and I really like that. I've just added a gem file with a gem file lock to my directory, and I want to have the rake command available to my app.rb. So how do I add this to my Docker file? Well, pretty easily. I just type run and bundle. So now when this set of instructions gets down to this bundle here, it'll just run the bundle command before it says, yeah, I'm all built and ready to go. So let's kind of see what that looks like. So I'm just typing Control R just to quickly search my history. And there's the command I ran before. And what you can see there, that was quite quick, is it went through. It built the image, and it actually ran bundle and done all this, which is quite cool. If we were to run this again, it actually knows that it's bundled and has a snapshot of what it looks like, so it's actually going to be super quick, and it won't explicitly add this output. So if you're kind of wondering where that output's gone, it's because it's used the cache, so that's nice and fast. Okay, so let's run this thing. Let's do Control R again and just type run. There you go. So it says, hello, I'm in Docker. It still works. So that's quite cool. What if we wanted to have a quick look at what was in this directory? So I'm going to quickly just type sh at the end to here. And that's going to give us a shell session into that Docker image. So we can see everything's all there. If I was to strike rake.t, it says it doesn't have a rake file, but it's actually there and running. So that's quite cool. Most Docker files used in production will often include this line saying run apk. This is just saying go install some of these extra packages I know I'll need to help Ruby Gems install correctly. So there's a few to install Nukiguri correctly and get FFI bindings working as well. I totally recommend having a quick look at my Ruby starter kits Docker Rails template file. It kind of has everything set up just to kind of get the base Rails working perfectly, and it will save you an awful lot of time. That was a really brief introduction to Docker. I hope you found that quite useful. In future episodes, I'm planning to cover things like deploying Docker and Docker Compose, so make sure you subscribe to this channel to see more. If you like this video, please remember to smash that like button and also maybe give me a follow on Twitter. I always appreciate that. I'm at MikeRogers0 on Twitter. And I'll see you next time.